In this episode of Podcast Tactics, you will get podcasting tips and advice from a solo podcaster that shares insightful thoughts, opinions, and ideas on a wide variety of topics. Remember to join the mailing list at podcasttactics.com so you can keep learning about podcasting, get inspired, and stay motivated. I'm James, the host of Podcast Tactics. Thanks for listening. Let's get into it. Joining me right now is Giridhar from Hyderabad, India. Giridhar, thank you so much for being on the show.
Hi, James. Thank you so much for having me as your guest for today.
Fantastic. So I'm going to say, let's just dive right in and talk about your podcast. What's the name of your show and tell us what it's all about?
Yeah, sure. So my podcast name is Giridhar's Gardi. It's all about my personal experiences, ideas, and opinions on various subjects. So already it's the first season that I have started during the Corona COVID time and all. Mm-hmm. So it started from July to 2020. Actually, on my birthday, I released the trailer of this podcast because I wanted to start something new on my birthday.
I love that idea.
Yeah. So just exactly 2 days after that, I started releasing the episodes. I recorded everything previously and I started releasing everything slowly. So it is like I take a concept every week and I express my personal opinions, ideas, and even I share my personal experiences to all the listeners. So this is all something that is going on for now. But yeah, in the next season, even I would like to have the interview sort of conversations and all. So looking forward to it. Let's see how it goes.
That's awesome. So tell us, what was your aha moment for, you know, your podcast? How did you come up with the idea for this show?
Yeah, means from my childhood itself, at least from last 10 years or so as well, I had this idea. Like, I was quite impressed with the radio jockeys or radio personalities, I think that is what you call in US. So I just love such radio shows. I was quite impressed with them and I love the way they engage the audience. I love the way they play the songs in between. I love their accent. They even keep on saying so many things and they are highly creative. On a daily basis, they come up with some topic or the other and they speak on continuously about something. So being a talkative person by nature, even I felt like, yeah, somewhere even I should start this. But how to start, what to do, even I was not aware of anything as such. But slowly, from last 2 years or so, I was part of this Toastmasters club. So in Toastmasters, we had a project called podcast. So that's where I actually listened to this word for the first time. Oh, podcast. So what is this podcast about? When I Googled and searched everything, okay, I got to know some details about it. Oh, there's something called podcast wherein we can actually record our voice and let the world hear us. Wow, that's a great thing. So slowly I started to know about the apps and all from where we can actually do this podcast. And there was something called Anchor that was absolutely free. So I started doing it using Anchor. That's how it's gone. And I'm quite happy that I'm able to fulfill my passion now, along with the work or profession that I do.
That's really cool. So did I hear you correctly that at Toastmasters, when you started going there, that's where you heard about the concept of doing podcasts. Is that right?
Correct, James. There was indeed a project called Podcast, Create a Podcast, in one of the educational track we have. There's this project called Create a Podcast. Of course, I didn't do that one. But when we actually scroll down those projects, I had this habit of writing blogs. So I selected the write a compelling blog project instead of the podcast one. That was like a sort of elective for us in Toastmasters. So there what happened was I was really impressed with this podcast wala thing, because that's the thing that I got to know from Toastmasters. There I found this word and then I started Googling it. Okay, so this is podcast. This is just like a kind of radio show wherein we can actually let our voice listen to the world, or even bring on some guests, either friends or anyone in the in their areas of expertise, and we can have their interviews recorded, and we can be the host. In fact, I love hosting such things. Usually, I mean, even earlier as well, in our WhatsApp groups, I used to do this hosting. We had our college friends of around 60 members, 60, and I hosted a show called Target, wherein it is like a daily I target one member in that. So it is like I introduce them as I'm the host and they will be the guest for the day. I introduce them, I ask some questions to them, they have to answer, and after that I leave it to the group of other friends, wherein they can also ask the questions from their end. So at the end of the day, I drive the show completely. At the end of the day, I'll give them the score. Okay, this is how you performed. And also, hosting was also something that I really love. So podcast was like a scenario wherein the combination of hosting as well as my passion for radio jockey, everything it was getting fulfilled. At the same time, while creating content, I'm even writing my blogs. So multiple things which I love were actually happening through podcast.
Well, you sound like a very driven person. I have to ask, what is it that you do for a living?
Okay, I am a software engineer.
Uh-huh. Okay. Do you feel like that kind of helps you stay organized? And I mean, it sounds like you're taking on quite a bit.
Yeah. I mean, I love to do these extracurricular things. Of course, I like my job, but that is only to a certain extent. But beyond that, I always feel like doing something else. Because after 10 years or 20 years, when we look back and see what we did means no, we just did our daily course of activities and we went to job, we did that, we came back home and we slept. No, it shouldn't be like that. There should be something apart from our daily routine. So we should have some memories. We should create some memories so that at least after 10 or 20 years, we feel so much accomplished and we feel proud of ourselves.
Let's circle back a little bit. Let's go back to your podcast. I want to get into like some of the challenges that you've had with, putting that show together. What kind of challenges have you been facing with that?
Yeah, sure. So starting at the time of starting my podcast, I was actually not aware of all this technical stuff, how to do. I mean, I know only this app called Anchor. Okay. I started recording my voice, but it was not so clear. It was not so loud. So that there is this technical challenge wherein, okay, people were very much impressed with my voice, the accent and everything, but they were not actually able to grasp the voice because it was so low and the background music, it was dominating the voice at the beginning. So what I couldn't even understand how to fix this problem, I started using one more app wherein I started amplifying my voice just to make it a little louder. And then I started applying the background music. It was little better. But after that, one of my friend who has also started a podcast, he suggested me one more app called Dolby, wherein we get a perfect audio quality. And it just made my job easier. And that was the biggest challenge that I faced so far in my podcast. That's only related to the technical stuff.
Yeah. I can relate to that. The technical challenges are for sure. they're exactly that. They are definitely challenging. Let's talk about, the flip side of that coin. Let's talk about the successes that you've had.
On a very positive note, I got a strong wave of positive responses from a lot of my friends in my network only. Of course, I couldn't actually go beyond my network so far. But so far, whoever have listened to my podcast, I couldn't even get one negative review from them. Because whatever people gave, at least maybe it can be with respect to my content or with respect to my voice or with respect to the creativity that I was showing in the podcast so far, I was only able to get the positive comments so far. And it was quite encouraging for me to come up with something new every week and do this with a lot of passion. So I feel that itself is a success. I don't want to have a number of subscribers and start getting some money or something as such. Because ultimately, our personal satisfaction is something that is beyond everything. That is what I feel.
In terms of your process, how do you go about approaching, episode creation? Like, do you just, keep a journal and, write down ideas and then say, yeah, I'm going to go with that. So talk us a little bit about your process.
Okay, sure. It was like, frankly speaking, from last 3 to 4 years, I started writing blogs. So I was a blogger. So that helped me quite a lot with respect to the content, because for now I am doing solo, and those blogs, actually I can change some things here and there. And ultimately, if I feel that content, because after some years, whatever we feel right today may not be right for us tomorrow. So we may have some changes here and there with respect to the content, but ultimately it made my job a little easy. That is what I can say, because I already have some content and I can actually do only some changes here and there. And yeah, so, okay, I have this content, I have this title, I have this topic, and yeah, I can easily go ahead with recording the episode. So that made my job easier. At the same time, it is not that I had so many articles or so. It was quite hard for me to continue writing every week or every month in that way earlier. But now that I'm doing a podcast, it became a mandatory thing for me. So at least once in a week, I feel like sitting down, and yeah, usually I feel like talking about a topic, I start thinking about it for 1 week, whatever the activity that I'm doing. So I at least morning time, as soon as I wake up, when I brush up, so that's the time usually I get beautiful thoughts, because early morning we would be off very cool and clean mind, right? So we don't have any other thoughts that time. So I usually get those creative thoughts early in the morning, and then I keep on thinking about it at least for 1 week. Ultimately, at the end of the week, I'll put all my thoughts organized in a perfect blog, or like a perfect speech in a Toastmasters club. Even that experience is helping me here, that I can say definitely. So I'll keep everything in an organized way. Ultimately, I would go ahead with the recording of the episode.
So tell me, what do you want your listeners to get out of listening to your podcast?
Yeah, earlier I thought Anchor, Spotify, or Google Podcasts, and all these areas wherein I felt it would be better. But right now I am really enjoying people listening to my podcast on YouTube, because YouTube is like a default app wherein it is available on everyone's mobile. But when it comes to Anchor or Spotify or Google Podcasts, it is something that rarely people install. So I started making YouTube videos, and that attracted audience a lot, and people are actually enjoying YouTube videos. So yeah, I would love my audience to actually listen to the YouTube videos. That's where I want to concentrate more.
Okay, let me ask my question a little bit differently, because I thank you for that answer, but I was wondering, like, you know, when you put these episodes together, you know, is there a takeaway message that you want people to walk away with?
Yes, definitely. In every episode, I would love to give a message towards the end, because ultimately it shouldn't be like people listen to my episode for 5 or 10 minutes and okay, yeah, that's fine, this happened. No, it shouldn't be the case. There should be something, some takeaway wherein they can relate my experience to themselves, or they can take a lesson out of it. So like even in the initial episode, wherein I spoke about my migration. Means usually I come from a small town to Hyderabad. So Hyderabad is like, it's a city in India. It's a great developed city in India. And I started fulfilling my dreams. I spoke about my dreams actually. In the migration itself, how I migrated from a small town to a city, from a college student to an employee, and from a housewife to a householder. So it's all like the transformation from something from nothing to something at least. So there, what people can actually take away from that story is, it is that our city, we don't have to worry about anything in the city. As soon as you come, this city teaches us so many things. The city, you don't have to worry. You all you have to do is trust the process and go ahead. That's the city takes care of everything.
Right. It's the city. It's like the city is kind of like life.
And that city never sleeps, actually. We may sleep, but the city never sleeps.
That's so beautiful.
So in the process of heading towards our goal or destination, we may get diverted due to many things. But at least for some time, if we can take our eyes off our busy life and try to find that special feel, which our city usually gives to our life, that gives a beautiful and meaningful value to our life. That's the kind of message that I would like to give through a small story as well. That's just an example to your question.
I'm curious about, you know, what your hopes are for the future of your podcast. Where do you see that going?
Okay. Coming to hopes, at some point, even I would like to have so many subscribers to my channel, like every other, because I want the world to hear me. And even if we are here or not, ultimately our work would remain. That is something that I believe. And of course, at the same time, I don't want to concentrate only on the monetization perspective, because it is my passion, because I love to do it. Whether I reach that monetization stage or not, I would love to continue my podcast. So earlier I thought, okay, I would do some 50 episodes, I would do some 100 episodes, and let's keep a full stop to that. But now my perspective slowly it got changed. Okay, let's do to whatever extent we can. To whatever extent our time permits. So let's keep doing. Let's not concentrate on the end result. Let's trust the process and let the process take care of the end result.
That is a very wise approach to this endeavor that we are on.
Thank you.
Let's dive into one of your episodes. I listened to your most recent episode. That's episode 33, the one about leadership. You know, your style is very much, it's thoughtful, it's introspective, it's meditative. I enjoyed listening to your storytelling. It was very much on point and compelling. So I appreciated, the story that you were telling. But also, I did end up, like, after the episode, I did end up kind of having this a takeaway where, what I learned or what I got from that episode was that, leadership is about enabling that the possibility that people have in others, and letting them fulfill that.
Thank you so much, James. In fact, it means a lot. It came as a surprise for me that you already listened to one of my episodes, and I felt really great about it. And I just would like to know, if you are okay with it, any suggestions from your end for improvement, because it is something that every one of us would look at.
Sure. Yeah. So, one of the things that I did notice was that the I don't know if you're using like an echo or a reverb on your audio. I did feel like that at times was a little bit hard to hear what you were saying. It was causing a little bit of a, the echo was a little bit more, it made it hard to understand the words that you were saying. Like right now when I'm listening to you, it is very, it's very clear, and I don't feel like you need that echo in there. So I would suggest, just let your voice stand on its own, because your voice is beautiful, and I think you should just let that come across. It doesn't need to be, tweaked in that sort of way, if that makes sense.
Yeah, thank you so much. In fact, that's the improvement which I even got to know from two or three people. But I just would like to understand, is it too hard to listen, or is it just okay, or is it something that can be ignorable? Because those were the recordings I already did earlier, and that was an empty room by chance. So that's the reason there was an echo.
That makes sense now.
Now this is not an empty room. That's the reason this is perfectly clear.
Got it. Okay. Yeah. Your voice is so perfect right now too. So yeah, whatever room you're in right now, continue recording in that room.
sure. Because after I received this feedback, I started coming to this room only. Whenever there is a podcast or recording or anything as such, I changed my room completely, because earlier I couldn't receive that feedback and I thought, okay, everything was going good. Even I felt it was fine. I don't know. But yeah, as soon as I heard people saying about this echo thing, even I was able to correlate that. Okay. Yeah, it was true. That's right. So what do you say? Is it something that can be ignorable, or is it impacting more?
So I first started listening to your episode on Anchor, And then I went over to YouTube, and I don't know if you had them your podcast transcribed or if you enabled the automatic transcription, but that helped. So I ended up listening to it on YouTube and you know, just kind of keeping an eye on the subtitles. So I do feel like they can continue to stand on their own. I would just say moving forward, you know, like continue to record in that space that you're in right now and let your voice really resonate, because it's, you know, I think that with that bed of music that you've got going on, which I really loved, you know, it added to the kind of vibe of your stories. You know, I just I think you're going to be heading in the right direction by, you know, producing, you know, in that space that you're currently in right now.
Oh, sure. I mean, sorry to again ask you once again.
It's okay.
I mean, is it something that can be ignorable, or is it creating more impact with whatever episodes that I did so far? That's the only thing that I would like to know.
I would say there is an impact, you know. I don't know if it's something that would stop me personally from listening to it. You know, I would, knowing that you're on YouTube, I would just, you know, continue to listen to you on, you know, your early episodes on YouTube. So, you know, I don't think it's something that is totally full stop, you know, like, you know, it needs to be redone if that's what you're considering.
Okay, fine, thank you. Because if there is some impact kind of thing, earlier I was not even aware of this, but slowly when people started saying it, very recently I got to know this from people, started saying this, okay, I was able to correlate this thing. And then from then I was a little worried whether, because I already have some recorded episodes as well that are yet to be released. So that's the reason I'm a little bit worried about this.
You know, I don't know. I mean, I would say that if you've got the time and you haven't released them yet, you know, maybe go ahead and reproduce them again, you know, in that space that you're in. Because I do think that, you know, it would benefit from that, you know, as you're moving forward, just, well, not just, but, you know, if you've got the time, you know, redo them.
Sure.
What is the best experience you've had happen because of your podcast?
Like I think already I said, the people's comments means I was able to receive only the positive feedback from people. It's like people whom I know, but I wasn't in touch with them for so many years. Still, we would have their contact on WhatsApp or Facebook or any social media. So still they were trying to approach me, and they were commenting with a positive response saying, wow, Giridhar, after a long time, we were able to see you on in something different and something new you were doing. And that's a podcast. And these were the things that every one of us can easily correlate. And these were some of the best things that you were actually doing. So the people's positive feedback is something that actually, it makes us feel happy. So I think that's the best thing that happened to me so far.
Giridhar, tell us, you know, where can listeners find out more about you and find out more about your podcast?
Yeah, like I said, in YouTube, I have my channel, Giridhar Skaradi. So in YouTube, every week I release them. At the same time, all my podcast episodes are available on Anchor, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and also the other distribution channels from where the Anchor actually distributes this podcast.
Well, Giridhar, thank you so much for speaking with me and coming on the show. I do appreciate it.
Sure, James. Thank you so much to you as well. It's like a two-way process for both of us. Even you as well as me, we were able to learn something new out of this interview.
Absolutely. So I'd love to keep in touch with you. You know, I hope you would come on, you know, further down the road, give me an update on how things are going. We'll see how things are progressing for you. Does that sound like a plan?
Sure. Definitely, James. I would be in touch with you. At the same time, I would look forward for you as well to be a guest on my podcast.
I would love to do that. Please do not hesitate to reach out and let me know when you want to make that happen, and we'll make it happen for sure.
Sure. Thank you, James. Thanks a lot for having me.
Thanks again to Giridhar. Check the show notes for links to learn more about Giridhar and his show, Giridhar's Garrity. Please share what you got out of this episode by leaving a review on podchaser.com. You can find out how to do this in the show notes, and do let me know what you need from me to make this show even better for you. And make sure you follow Podcast Tactics to keep learning more about podcasting in future episodes. Thank you.